Jesus. Why should I?
Now let us not talk of assumptions.
He alone has.
Even now, I'll tell you something. I'll tell you something. Even in the court of law, assumption cannot be used.
No, it's not assumption, bro. You come here, you tell
me. You are assuming that. Right now, you are assuming that Baba Talisha.
And then you come again.
Are you aware that even in the court of law, hearsay and rumors.
Are you aware? Peter,
hearsay and rumors.
Peter, you are deviating. Stop that. You are deviating from the questions. Wachana na court of law. If it comes to the court of law, bro, you cannot stand with me.
Usikule siku tatu, usioge na usimpigie simu. Mungu ni nani? Kutoka nje wakalivaa zile pesa ya mganga, wakasema mganga ni fala. Kufika tu hapo nje tena watu watatu wakaona duka ya kangumu, na aliambua sikule siku tatu, akanunua kangumu na maji, na aliambua asikunywa na asioge. Aliambua sinikon, akanipigia. Hello, Pira, how are you? Nikamwambia poa sana my love, nakupenda kama sukari. Akageuka wenye walikuwa hapo, akamwambia naenda kuona mzee, na mtu alikuwa amenitext inbox, huyu mtu anakuendea kwa mganga. Sasa nikamwambia alipewa dawa siku tatu naye, nikamdanganya, nikamwambia nampenda sana, nikakosa kutokea. Unajua kitu alifanya next episode? Akaendea boksa zangu chafu, my friend, akazivaa. Kwanza alizikojolea na akavaa kwa nyumba nazo. TikTok hii. Jiji mnasema mmejiolea mambo. Nyamaza. Nyamazena tujafika hapo. Ikakuja siku ya Peter is hacking my phone. Akaamua kuchangiwa na TikTokers. TikTokers wakachanga pesa ya si. Akaambua sinipe details. Aliponunua hivi, alipoweka laini mpya, akanipigia nayo. Hello Pira, nimebaya simu shak du 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 du, baby shak du du du. Aya, hiyo pia nikafunga. Akaambiwa tena, akaenda kaambia watu, na hama I am not safe. Akatumaniwa pesa ya kuhama. Na kuambia tulinunua jacket, ni jangu. Kwa tama ni nini tulinunuanga, tukaenda Ruai ku enjoy pesa. I swear, tukafika Ruai, tuka enjoy hizo pesa, tukakuja tena akachangiwa tena. Nilikuja kushikwa mara ya kwanza na kina Yola, alinifichanga kwa choo, na ndio maana kwambia fear women. Akasema siko na siko nipata. Ulisema naposhindwa kwa birthday, pia akasombwa polisi wakamkujia. Unajua Yola kazi yake ilikuwa anauza isiongeki na sudari milalawe wa Kenya. Akasema na atafuta lizo na kuenda Dubai because mimi ndio toxic. Akasaidiwa akaenda Dubai. Si pia mimi nikaenda Dubai. Pira. Firea, niko Dubai pia.
Mm-hmm.
Nikasema sikuji ngo. Sikuji. Sikuji. Juzi Dubai. Baka akaposte. Ndeni kwa post yake. Mwane. Akiposte. Akisema MVPs in Dubai and he cannot look for me. Nikajiambia. Riswa. Pepo za my ex. Shitu kwa jina. Na kuna ex wangu aliye move on. Pepo shitu wali na kataa kwa jina. Nimekataa hapa pepo. Za ex. Sahi ameniachilia. Sahi ameniwachilia kabisa. Singina nakanga tibia niambia nimekupatia 10 years utangetanga welcome back. He? Hizo 10 years. Takuwa mbali. Hata hii Kenya sikanyaki tena. Sataki kuniacha.
Nasema 10 years is a no.
Anyway, to the watchdog. Ah, wewe unaitwa umbu wa kweli. Ama sio nini? Unajua ni translation. To the watchdog. Umbu wa kweli. Ama inaitwa
umbwa mtazamaji.
Tujazama mkipatana kwa hoteli Mlolongo. Nyama zake ni ya kukulana. Una shout.
Oh, brother.
Sasa tuzote niambia. Mimi najua saa hii wanang'ang'ana sana, walisema mimi najua kitu. They said in their WhatsApp vile tutafanyia Peter Kioi ataokotwa tu. Hivyo ndio walisema. Na sasa mimi nangoja waje waniokote. Unajua you people you don't know.
Mm-hmm.
You people you want to come and okota me in the forest. Kujeni tu. Kujeni tu. Mniokote. I will tell you for free. Kujeni. The way you want to come, just come. Just come. You will find Bira.
Unajua kuna kitu ili happen na Muti. Muti alisemanga account yake itafungwa. Account yako kwanza ulikama ukasema venye umeconfirm umse sio gari, account yako ikaenda. Muti akasema tu, yani alisema leo kesho account yake ikaenda.
Yeah.
Mbona mention hawa say lazima
wewe nikwambie truth watchdog. Truth watchdog people think that I am against looking for justice for Jira. But not. Wakati ilianza kwenda kwa channel ya imetoka kwa justice ikaenda kwa pesa ikaanza kwa attacking tuonge to honestly that's the interest ilinitokanga. But if it is for justice for Jira I have never at your story niongelelea ule mwanamke wa ya ule mwanamke wa Kasarani. I was the first person to go there usiku nilikuwa naenda kukunywa pombe huko Kasarani Mirema nikamwacha nini kaangalia ule mwanamke analalamika kwa live uliza watu nikafika hapa kaniambia hajakula nilikamtumia 2000 shillings
ya alinisho aliniambia uliko hapo
na mimi kumtumia si kumtumia juu ya shof because nilipata ile situation ya pale hospitali. Na pia madaktari walikuwa na mhandle. I felt bad. Do you understand? So, mimi nika back off kidogo, nione kama kuna watu, kama madaktari wataka change. But nilisema hii Ijumaa, naenda maandamano kwa hospitali ya St. Francis. Hakuna vile utatreat watu vibaya, wakufe, it is your own negligence, alafu unataka bado alipie. Unaona? Huyu mwanamke alisema, ametobole wa mara, that's number one. Yes. Akasema ametolewa ovaries. Yes. Number two. Akasema ametolewa uterus. Number three. Na alisema hizi vitu alifanyiwa when she's unconscious. If you are a true professional, you cannot do things without a witness, either family member or somebody uyo mwenye unamfanyia a sign kwamba nimekubali ni give you consent mweze kufanya hizi vitu.
True.
Sasa, kwa nini daktari akuja akipata mtu ako very unconscious, haezi jelewa, haezi fanya kitu, hata hajapatiana consent, hata kama alisaini akikuwa hapo, I am telling you for sure, kama huyu mwanamke hakuwa na shida na ovaries, na uterus, na haingefaa kutolewa, why could they not wait? That's number one. Number two, kama ni makosa ya daktari kutoa wakatoboa uterus because wanasema alitolewa nini, anasema alitolewa uterus, akatolewa ovaries na akadungwa. Kama ni makosa ya daktari kumdunga hapo, do you think it is the right of the patient to pay? It is the responsibility of the patient to pay back kitu ambayo wewe ulifanya. Okay. Sawa, she is alive. Has she confirmed that her kidneys are all there?
No, she hasn't.
Again, now the bill is 900,000. Bado mmemfanyia hizo vitu zote na bado amjamfanyia bado mnamnyima chakula. Nilifika hapo nikakuta kuna matunda, I think ni tano ama sita peke yake hapo juu, anahitaji kukula. Mtu amefanyiwa surgery, hata wale wamefanyiwa CS, na sidanganyi kama nadanganya waseme wale ambao wanawake wamepitia surgery, lazima ukue na chakula hapo, kama si chakula kinywaji kama uji, ni very necessary to keep you hydrated, to keep you going. You must be very strong because you're going through hardship, you're going through the process of healing. Hawezi pona kwanza kama hawezi kuwa hawezi pona kwanza kama hawezi kuwa kama hauna nini ndio nini kama hauna hauna joto kwa mwili. The woman was suffering, anaachiwa mpaka choo inajaa kwa kitanda siku mbili. How is that now? And if you stand to say, you know, you are right, you are silenced. I left the hospital by telling these doctors, you should be responsible for everything that is happening. So Friday to the watchdog, if you are available, you know, people think that I hate you. I don't hate you. I have no space to put hate on me, on anyone. If you are available, you can meet at St. Francis with people who can come so that we can question the hospital, because the government is not questioning the hospital. And St. Francis has not been called out. The hospital has not only been called out by the one patient. It is several people who are complaining about St. Francis Hospital Kasarani. And I'm telling you this without fear. Even this police station called Kasarani Police Station, that is where bulk of cases are there. That is where fraud is happening. That's where conning of 190 happens. That is where that is where people wanakuwa mishandled. And let me tell you, hata ukishika mtu, you have the right, and he has the right ya kuuliza mnishikia nini na ni kwa nini mnipeleka hapa na mnanitaka. That is the hospital St. Francis, Mama Lucy Hospital, and Pumwani have this habit. And now it is the time for us to stand for ourselves if the government is not standing for us. It is the time that you should be strong for your neighbor when they need you, because you don't know what tomorrow holds. Okay?
Yes.
So, true. It is the right time for you as a Kenyan to speak out loud of what you are going through, because you may never know what the other will go through, and it is through you that can somebody that somebody can get justice through you. If you keep quiet and they keep quiet, who will talk?
Exactly.
I, Peter Kioi, said I fear nobody, and trust you me, I'm not intimidated, and I stand to be corrected when I'm wrong. I will always stand for those people ambao wanapata injustice in the society, and trust you me to the watchdog. If you and I and others will hold each other's hand, we can move mountains. We can move mountains. By Friday, I said this morning yesterday, and this is again today. By Friday, if you guys in that hospital will not discharge that woman to better healthcare, we'll come there. And for real, we will come, because we don't need you guys to keep on harassing patients, and that's the truth. And that's the truth.
Bro, leo nataka tulizane maswali ngumu. Uko ready?
Yeah, no problem. I can answer questions.
Mina nataka tulizane maswali ngumu sana.
Mhm.
Na ziko ubaya. Peter, for example, sahi tuseme uko Ngong Hills.
Mhm.
Ukipigiwa simu uambiwe niaje Peter? Uko wapi? Ni Ngong Hills. Aha. Kuna kitu inafanyika huko Meru. Peter yuko Meru. Na anything yenye me happen Meru, kama nimekupigia simu, ni mimi ndio nakutumia hizo mapicha. Nikwambie cheki hapa Meru kuna sawa na chama matumba ama na chama mtura.
Mhm.
So lazima mimi mwenye nilikupigia simu na exist. Hapo tuko sawa?
Yeah. Sure.
Sasa mtu akikama aseme mimi ndio niko na picha za simu peke yangu. Na polisi. Huyo alikutumia picha ni nani na ulikuwa Ngong Hills?
Mm-hmm.
Mimi na disagree na vitu mingi sana. Na nitamuita Faustin, mimi sitamuita Baba Tim. Sababu kuna mwanamke alinikujia hapa na ujinga ati sijui dini mgonjwa umzana itaji peace. Mimi nikasema mimi siko against peace na siko against mtoi na hata sijui unataja mtoi hapo anini. But kuna vitu mingi hapa zenye mimi nauliza maswali inakuwa mimi na hit. Bro, I don't know this person na unajua mimi hata sijai meet. Simjui. So mimi nauliza tu maswali siko ubaya. Anything that happens to Peter Kioi na nijue. Ama instincts zangu ziniambie zi. Hakuna mwenye Peter atakunywa pombe akufe. Huyu mtu anakunyonga keg tank mzima. Na si ya kwanza ni 10 najua. Haizi kufa na keg. Mimi nitasema hizi glasses na hizi mavichupa hizi ziangaliwe. Huu kijana lazima kuna mtu ameweka unga hapa ndani. Peter hizi kufa na pombe. Namjua. Na akikunywa akitosheka anendanga kwake. Na hajawahi fika mahali hizi tembea. Mnanidanganya si pombe liwa Peter. Siamini. Na nikifanya uchunguzi ni feel walikuwa. Bro, siwezi nyamaza. Tutakosana tu ni sawa, mnichukue vibaya, mtaniambia Peter alikuwa bibi yako ni sawa, alikuwa bibi yangu, lakini hata kama ni bibi yangu hakukufa na pombe.
Okay, can we come to, like you said, you are asking for hard hard questions. Can we now focus on being straightforward, yani being straightforward, yani sema tu exactly. hivi na uliza hii swali. Yes,
swali yangu nauliza hivi. Mbona Baba Talisha yeye peke yake ndiye akona picha za site ya accident peke yake, hakuna mse mwingine ama uko nazo?
Okay, did you confirm with him that he has the photos?
No, he said it's his words. He said on the screen, you can see even comment section confirming. Okay. He said himself, not we have the record as well.
Okay. You, as an individual, you say that you went to the DCI and gave out your information.
Yes.
So far, what is the response from the DCI?
I don't think I should give that because it's in progress, but just to give you a heads up, there was so much stupid questions that I was asked. First of all, I was asked, are you an immediate family member? I said, no, I'm not an immediate family member to one Brian Chira, the deceased. And then they asked, it will be much more effective if you know, the first time you don't know the process. So the process is you have to write an anonymous letter, which I did not know. So I learned there. But I have to go back, write to the director of criminal investigation, an anonymous letter. Then from there, I think the will be taken to the ODPP, and then the ODPP will ask or question that this matter should be looked into. I looked at that process. I said, okay, I'll go back, but this is what I have right now. Can't this start something? You have to be an immediate family member. Kama ungekuwa maybe cousin, brother or something like that, ingekuwa much more easier. So nikakasirika, by the way, nikauliza, sasa tuseme nimeona chokora amegongwa na gari, na sijui babake mamake, na mtu mwenye amemgonga ni gari KBC CDF, siwezi kuja kushtaki? There was a huge argument argument there mpaka watu wakafikiria nataka kuleta vita, so I got so mad. But later on I wrote the letter, and then there is this lady, I don't want to mention her name, she told me, by the way, you are making a lot of sense, sijui mbona watu wanakupeleka hivi. So kulikuwa hapo na mushkil sana. I went there 3 times physically, but I wrote the letter. But from my okay, from my perspective of things, I see they are not taking it serious.
According to you, according to your inner self,
yes,
do you have anything against Faustin?
No, no, as in personal.
Mm-hmm.
No, 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 no. We have never crossed path.
Do you talk?
Never. We have never talked. I don't have his contact. I don't
have
know whether
have you ever tried to make a move to ask him, Baba Talisha, on a like making a call to him or asking him through WhatsApp, asking him like, first thing, why are you the one only having this? And he answers you directly.
No, 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 no. We have never communicated. In fact, I do not have his number. For the record, I don't have his number.
Why don't you have the number? And are you friends?
No. A stranger. How am I a friend to a stranger? He doesn't know. I don't know whether he knows me, but I don't know him. I learned about him when Chira died, apparently.
Suppose that you don't know him. Why don't you make a move of first making a friendship with him to ask him directly?
Bro, are you mad? Why should I make friendship?
Okay, that means you have emotional intelligence.
Why should I make friendship to a stranger? Like, hey, niaje bro.
Why not? If you're a stranger, because I don't know you either, right? We have not met in person, but we talk.
No, never.
Thank you. Now, if you are for justice, you will be an open book.
I'm a very
open you would book. Allow. You will allow questions and allow answers, allow some criticism, positive or negative, because you are for justice. You will accommodate anything. Now, have you ever met Chira in person?
Never, never.
But the person in question has met Chira.
Yes, they have been together for some
that
time,
means,
including the house.
He knows him. That means he knows him better.
Yes.
Now, could it be better of you to come first and ask yourself, if this person was available for Chira when he was alive and tried to make a step to, first let us agree, did Faustin help Chira when he was alive?
Did
Faustin help Chira when he was alive? Right. So do you think
did Faustin help right now when he was alive?
Yeah.
But also he's got on the record saying that yeah, you can never have a friend like Chira.
Yeah, no. That is after. Did he ever tulisema tulizana maswali ngumu na tuko ready, sawa? Now, did he ever help Chira when he's alive? Yes, he did. Do you think that he can accommodate something
somehow,
that
has he did somehow? Extent
he did help him. A help is a help, it doesn't have quantity, it just has quality.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, whether he was looking for fame or he was doing it for views, but he helped. A help is a help. Now, my question to you is, Chira was suffering when he was alive, and you said that he said it loud that I'm suffering.
Yes,
why were you not available for him when he was alive and was sick to help him?
Because you people were not ready for my help. My help was not to give Chira money or a place to sleep. Mine was simple. Chira needs mental health care. He needs to be taken somewhere, okay, which many of you are.
Can you tell somebody? Okay. Can you tell somebody that is hungry? You need to find food while you have food on the table.
Come again.
Can you tell somebody that is alive and is hungry that you need to find food while you have food on the table?
It depends on how much I have on my table.
Can you offer some?
If I have enough to offer to someone else. But
sometimes
it is just
sometimes Chira needed something to eat so that you can have mental health. So Baba T gave him food. Did you?
I did, but I didn't brag about it on media.
You never.
I never bragged on media or how or what I have done for Chira. I remember when Mweti was raising money for him to go to Lamu using a SGR. I did send my money.
At one point, you are recorded saying that it is wrong to offer Chira money.
Yes, true.
Well, Chira said himself that he needed money.
Exactly.
So those who helped him did wrong, right?
Exactly.
Thank you. What step did you take?
You guys blocked me. Apparently, I was the bad one because I don't want to see
fundraising
money.
Because what you did was to open live to say he doesn't need money.
True. Chira didn't.
Are you aware? Okay. Let's go hard. You said let's go hard. You go hard. On your previous sentence, you said that you have never met known Chira. He was never your friend.
And up to date, he's not.
Thank you. You can never offer help to a stranger.
I do help. Yesterday, we helped a stranger by the name Sleet. We fundraised here 10,000 yesterday.
Now, let's go straight. Let's go straight. Did you, at any capacity, do you understand that Baba Talisha at one point took Chira to a mental health facility seek help?
Which one?
Are you aware of that?
I am aware that Baba Talisha said mental health care places will not help Chira. He's on record. We have the video.
No, I'm asking. Are you aware that he did that?
Where? Tell me where.
He took him for therapy and paid money.
Where?
If you are not aware of Chira, you can never understand
him. Where did he take him to therapy?
I'm telling you. Listen. Now, let us go straight. Do you understand at one point Chira and Baba Talisha needed to help Chira so much, even offered the family food in the absence of Chira?
Malaika and the
house. One day, let me tell you. One day, Chira was in Mombasa. Or at Mombasa, and
don't
the family
you
needed
any of my questions. You're asking questions.
Listen, no. So to me, say matter in hard. To end hard. Bila.
Is your hard ujibu?
Bila had feelings. Bila had feelings. Now he took food for the family when Shosho was complaining. Are you aware
but
of that?
But he also ate there. He found food. He ate.
No, did you? Are you agreeing that he took food there?
What did you warn Chira about? That his friends will kill him. What did you warn Chira about?
Listen, you first have to answer, then I will answer you.
Okay, I'm listening.
What I'll tell you honestly is you have a personal issue with Faustine.
No. What is the question?
The question is, you are asking about the photos. You have never made a step to ask Baba Talisha.
Why should I make a step? Did he make a step?
And now, my biggest question of the day. Why are you asking me questions that belongs to Faustine?
Yesterday, and today you confirmed on your sober that whatever you said was true. And we know apparently, as you claim here, that Faustine was a friend to Chira. And you said Chira's friends killed Chira.
How many friends? Out of all friends of Chira, why did you only pick Faustine?
I haven't picked on Faustine. There is nowhere I'm recorded or anywhere I have stated that.
Right now, you have picked Faustine alone.
I just asked one question, which you have not answered.
Now, my answer is this. My answer is this. If I don't know, but if Baba Talisha is only the person who has Chira's photos or who doesn't have
on the side,
because
on the side, point of
he was the only concerned friend.
and the only one who took photos while he was in Mount Longonot, while Chira Wright is in Morera.
The question stands to be is, the biggest question is Babatalisha, was Babatalisha helpful when Chira was alive? Yes. No. When he, well, now, when he died, he also took the responsibility of helping him. And bro, now, let me ask you another question. Have you confirmed the photos? Have you ever seen any of the photos?
Why should I confirm? If I come here, I
have
tell
you ever
you,
seen?
I am leaving.
Have you seen one?
Supposed to come and tell me.
Have you seen?
Then why should he lie to
come
his friend?
Seen, why come should he lie? Come first.
Why should he
no,
lie?
Not
to
lying.
The people who fund then.
Do you have the photos? Have you ever seen one of the scene?
Why should I have photos? Why should I
now? Let us not talk about
assumptions.
Even now, I'll tell you something. I'll tell you something. Even in the court of law, assumption cannot be used.
No, it's not assumption, bro. You come here, you tell
you are
me
assuming that right now you are assuming that well, Babatalisha.
And then you come
okay.
again.
Are you aware? Are you aware that even in the court of law, hearsay and rumors.
Are you aware? Were you aware? Peter,
hearsay and rumors.
You are deviating. Stop that. You are deviating from the questions. Wachana na court of law. If it comes to the court of law, bro, you cannot stand with me at that decor. And I will defeat you very early in the morning. The question
you are the last person.
Why should
to the watcher, let me tell you what people perceive about you.
Camera,
what people perceive about you and what I will tell what you are. First,
okay. What am
the
I?
First thing you are. The first thing you are. You just imagine things
no.
which are not
no,
real.
Don't. No.
Number
okay.
two.
Mm-hmm.
Number two. You like hearsay and rumors.
No, lies.
Okay, if that is lie, let me ask you. Have you seen the photos from Babati's phone?
Why should I see the photos from Babati's phone? What am I doing with Babati's phone?
Confirm to us that Babati has the photos.
Who is us?
To us, to the world one which is watching.
As who?
Show us the evidence that
I'm
Babati
asking you a question. You have answered none. Umejibu zero, like sufuri, zero.
Okay.